the function f of x is graphed, find f of 4. So this is a visual function definition, and it tells us visually for any input, and the inputs are on the horizontal axis, what's the corresponding output? So here when they're saying find f of 4, they're saying let's input 4 into this function. So let's find, so along the inputs, we're going to say 4 is our input. And what's our function definition tell us is the output? Well, when our horizontal axis, we're at 4 on the horizontal axis, we move up and see where are we on the vertical axis. And this blue graph, which is our function definition, shows us that when our input is 4, our output, we went all the way up to 8. You could view this vertical axis as our f of x, or as our output axis. So when our input is 4, our output, or when x is equal to 4, this is our x-axis, when x is equal to 4, f of x is equal to 8. Let's do a couple more of these. The function f of x is defined as f of x is equal to 2x squared plus 5x minus 7. Find the value of f of 3. So once again, f of 3, when we say f of 3, we're literally saying we're inputting 3 into the function. And this right over here is the function definition. So everywhere where we see an x, we will now replace it with a 3 to figure out what f of 3 is equal to. Unless we might even be able to do this in our heads, although if you find that confusing, I recommend that you do use some paper. So if x is 3, this will be 2 times 3 squared, so it's 2 times 9, which is 18. 18 plus 5 times 3, 5 times 3 is 15. 18 plus 15 is 33, minus 7 is 26. So when x is equal to 3, this whole thing evaluates to 26. So f of 3 is 26 if I did my mental mathematics correctly. Let's do one more of these. The function f of x is graphed. Find f of negative 9. So once again, our input here is negative 9. X is negative 9, so we go along the horizontal axis. And we see when x is negative 9, our function is at 1. So f of negative 9 is 1. So we stick the 1 right over there, and we got it right.